All right, guys, kind of coming to you today on a quick video about limit straps. We carry a full variety of limit straps in all different sizes. And you know, one of the main questions we have is like, what size limit strap do I need? So make a quick video, show you how to measure and get the right strap. Number one, you want to add tabs to the vehicle that are in line with each other. Whenever you're pulling on the strap, everything stays nice and straight, everything down here. So right now, whenever we're pulling this measurement, this is a 14-inch shock. You can just pull this right here. Right down in here, you've got 14 inches. So what we're gonna do is we wanna limit the travel just a hair to make sure this shock doesn't bottom out. So you get this measurement right here, and we're gonna measure it and call that 18 and a half from the center of this hole to the center of that hole. That's what you want to do on putting a limit strap on. So then you take that measurement and come around here to a little bit of an equation. Come here and zoom in on this thing right here. So you've got 18 and a half inches eye to eye, and you pretty much got to account for 1 inch of stretch per 12 inches of strap. So if you do a little equation, it's 0.083. 18 and a half times 0.083, 1.54. All right, so you subtract that from your overall length. 18 and a half mount width, 1.5 inches of stretch. You need to order a 17 inch strap. So whenever you put the 17 inch strap on here, you can see that like you can't get to it. But when we drop this axle down, pull that down. Put the nuts and bolts there. Take this little dude right here. Jason, tighten those up. And we use a stoger lock when we mount limit straps. Or just any kind of lock nut. Stoger lock is a nut with these little locks right in here. It just kind of locks the nut down. I like a stoger lock better than a nylock because there's nothing to melt out. What you want to go to, Jason's showing you right here, you want just enough that it'll pull straight every time. If that goes off, that it, you know, just that strap can always pull straight as the axle drops down. Tighten that bottom up, and then we'll show them the difference. Counted for 1.5 inches of stretch. It's 1 inch per 12 inches of strap. That's the biggest thing. And now that 14 inch shock is traveling right at 13 inches. And that's 13 inches of shock with pretty much no extras added to it, no extra force, anything else. You've got this shock in its sweet spot now, where it's safe to travel it. You've limited that travel just a little bit. This thing's actually gonna stretch more over time, and you're probably gonna dial it in to where you got that 13 and a half or so inches of shock out of that 14 inch shock travel. But you're not overextending your shock, and you've got a little bit of protection in there. The limit strap's doing its job. So that's the biggest question we were asked, is like, how do you measure it? And you measure it eye to eye, 1 inch of stretch per 12 inches of strap. Do a little bit of math, and that's how you order your limit straps.